today. We continue our series of lecture with our directors around Europe. So after Germany and the Netherlands, we're so happy to host with us today, Laureline Morel, director of the office in France. And I will let the floor to Laureline. Thank you everyone for being here with us today.
Bonjour everyone, shalom, shalom. So I am sorry, I don't speak any Hebrew, so I have to speak in English. So, except if you all speak French and we can share in French. No, nice try. Okay, so I am in charge of the office in Paris for the market of France and Belgium also. We are a team of three people, and let's start with the actual situation that we all know. So just a small reminder of what happened in France, because we don't have the same management of the crisis like you guys in Israel. So just some important dates between France and Israel for the COVID situation. So last year on March, Israel decided to close the border to all French people. So now from more than one year, all borders are closed. In France, we only got two lockdowns, but it's enough, right? So from February, we've got like a threat every week that we may have a new lockdown. But every Friday, we've got like, no guys, not for this weekend. So till now, we don't have a new lockdown, only, and I say only, a curfew. So we're supposed to be at home at 6 p.m. till 6 a.m. So basically everything in France is very slow. We are still in the middle of the crisis, not like you are more at the end. We are just in the middle in France, and we expect a lockdown in Paris because of the very bad figures that we got actually. So with all this so news, we've got a very good news last week on Friday. The Ministry of Tourism of France changed the law, and now 7 new countries, including Israel, are allowed from and to France. But on Monday, they send a message which cancel and replace this new announcement on Friday and say, okay, this country are allowed to come and from and to Israel, but let's say that travel is still not recommended for French people, okay? So open borders are open from and to Israel, but travel for French people are still not recommended. So there is two way of seeing the things, but let's say it's a new big step for the French tourism. And for you in Israel, is still closed for French people, so cross fingers. Voilà. Now I will show you some figures about the corona crisis in France. So we've got only 3% of the population will get the vaccine. So small step. When you know that the official campaign starts at the end of December, and after 2 months and a half, we only get 3%. So we're supposed to obtain in May more than 10 million of people vaccinated. So let's say it's 1 in 6 French people, which will be very great, but not like you, it's not half of the population we get vaccinated before September or October. But it's not only France, this figure are basically the same in all Europe, because they decide to buy all vaccine for all Europe to make a very good price. So that's the good news. We get vaccine for a very good price, but we don't get enough vaccine. So yeah, that's why. So as you can see, last week we reached more than 90,000 dead people in France. So it's very, very big figures that we've got. and we don't still have 100% of the target population we should be vaccinated at first. As you can see, we only reach 88% of this first target. So we take time before everything gets great and okay. So the situation of the country of France, as you know, France is the first tourist country in the world. So it's be a very, very big stop for all the tourism industry in France, for all the incoming, for sure. But now we will talk and focus on about the outgoing. But let's say that the French government gave a lot of help for all the French people who work in tourism, hotel, tour operator, travel agencies. They all get very, very big help for the French government. But whatever, it's still very, very difficult, because as you can see, there is one quarter of company were planning to lay off many people. And let's say that all the phone calls that I actually share with tour operators are only about this layoff plans and how people will leave, how many, and what is the plan for the next month about that. Because you need to understand that in France, many travel agencies are closed from last March of last year, and they never open again. So it's a zero activity for 1 year around. So it's basically a very, very nightmare for them. They try to minimize the loss. So they try to be reactive by changing their strategy, and they try to focus. I think, like for you, in Israel with domestic travel, to you know, to try to minimize the losses, and they create new products, many new products for the domestic travel, and they try to focus on the medium or flight. And usually this kind of product, people used to book them directly without the travel agency, without the tour operator, without anyone. They can book by themselves. But when you have a big challenge like this big crisis, all the tourism industry in France choose to propose this product with added service, like special offer, with a combo. They really try to add other services that the customer cannot find directly when they book themselves. So let's say that the tourism industry about that in France was very reactive by changing everything. And some big tour operators, let's say, like, if you know it, if you work on the French market, Asia, it's a big TO, and they are basically specialized on Asia because their name is Asia. And this summer they start to sell France, just to show you how people try to adapt their product and to adapt their work. And it was a success for them, even if all the brand is for normally long haul flight. They try to add and propose new product, and it was a pretty success. So it's a good news with all these challenges. So now I would like to show you all the trend of sale, because I think it's a good view about the sale on the French market. So I start with the sale of the tour operator and travel agencies, a few which are still open. As you can see, first, of course, it's still France with the domestic travel, because all borders are officially not really open. And there is a big increase if you see the figures of all the sales, like I said, for the domestic travel, because now it's one in two sales done in domestic travel directly by the professional, by the tour operator and travel agency. So there is a really new products on the domestic work. So there is a big adaptability of the network, as you can see with the sales. there is a lot of in the top 10 of the Europe destination because they are still open for French people like Spain, Greece, Italia. But as you can see, there is also two long haul flights, which are Dominican Republic and United Arab Emirates. Because here in France, their borders are still open. There is no quarantine and just a PCR test mandatory before the departure. And as you can see, when the borders are open and the destination keep on with communication, people go. So it's a good sign for the future, because if the borders are open, French people are not afraid to take flight and enjoy travel, as you can see with this both destination. And all combination and destination combined, as you can see, there is a loss of 88% versus last year. So let's say it's a rude time. Okay. I add also in the trend of sale, all the sale of online travel agency, because I think it's not the same way of selling, you know, because online travel agencies, they reach a lot of people during the crisis, and with the lockdown, people get more and more and more used to go and check directly on the digital. So OTA are definitely the next step. It was already a big step in the tourism, but for sure for the next year, it will be a big increase for them. So I speak with the two of them, VP Voyage, which was, if you know, Voyage Privé. Vente privée, excusez-moi, Vente privée Voyage, we changed the brand for VP Voyage, and Mr. Fly. So the both, if you compare the destination, the sale is basically the same as tour operators and travel agency. The big change is for Mr. Fly, because they sell flight only, which we can explain the figure about Tunisia, Morocco, Senegal, because we've got a lot of community in France, and I think they sell the flight only for the French community of this country who come back to their country for the summer. But there is a big difference between these two OTA. As you can see, VP focus the sale on the month of May. Okay, so they've got a lot of last minute because we're already in March. But for Mr. Fly, they say that they've got a lot of sales on July. So it's a good news also for the industry, because it seems that the French people are finally ready to book their travel for the summer. So if in Israel we can share and communicate about a reopen, I think French people can already book July and August. They are already prepared to book their travel for the summer. So it's a very good news. And also still Spain, Greece, Italy, Portugal. It's already the same, and you can saw also Dubai. So the next slide is just to show the Israel destination into the French market, because most people forgot, but it's okay, that we are the first market in Europe. So we are before Germany and Russia about figures and customers figures for every year. And for a major and historical market, let's say, we've got very good figures before the crisis, and we keep on with increase year after years. So it's a very good news for our market, because we are historical, so it's not easy to obtain a big increase in percentage when you are a major market. When you are a new one, it's easier, but when you are a big one, it's more challenging. So what this figure shows, that we reach new customer in the last few years, and I'm sure this kind of customer can keep on with increase after this crisis, for sure, it's just the beginning. So, French market. As you can see, there is no months without less than how many? I don't remember. With that, 15,000 customers, with less than 15,000 of customers every month. So what does that mean? That in the next 6 months, we can reach more than 200,000 tourists. So we've got a very big possibility of number and increase for the French tourists to go to Israel. But the next challenge will be flight, because we know we can make these big figures, but to obtain this big figure, we need flight to bring French people to Israel. And just a reminder, when we start 7 years ago with Efrat in the French destination, there were two airports which proposed direct flight. We've got Paris and Marseille. And thanks to the open sky, thanks to the marketing support, thanks to all the communication and the low cost, just before the pandemic situation, we had 6 new airports for direct flight. So we've got more than 100 flights per week, direct flight from France to Israel. So that's why we can reach these very good figures every month, because of the flight. When you've got a direct flight, it's easier for people to go to your destination. And you know, French people, when they live in Bordeaux or Toulouse, if you don't propose a direct flight, they don't go to your destination. They don't want to go through Paris or through another big city to make a medium haul flight. It's too long. They will take 3 hours just to go to Paris, then to have a 4 hours flight. So obtain a new direct flight is obtain a new customer. It's obtain a new potential to increase people to Israel. So that was the situation before the pandemic crisis. And during 1 year, we were so afraid about what will be the situation after. And let's say we've got a very optimistic news, because for this summer, we'll get all the airport with a direct flight to Israel. So it's a very good one, because if we've got all this offer for the flight, for sure, when the border will open, we can reach our figures for sure. Look at the flight. We've got every flight. The only lost we've got is Transavia from Lyon, just because, you know, with all the issue with Air France, and they need to rebrand many things, and they cancel the offer for the domestic flight in France, Air France, which was the brand up. So they cancel the brand, and they use the flight, the plane of Transavia, for all domestic flight in France. So that's why their plane, which normally used to go to Lyon, to Tel Aviv, were used to make Lyon, Nantes, Lyon, Bordeaux, Lyon, Paris, okay? So it's not like a very bad news, because it's another strategy, and it's normal that they try to increase domestic travel before, and then I'm sure for the next winter, we will get the flight back in Lyon from Transavia, for sure. So for me, if we've got the flight, we can get the tourists from French, for sure. So what are the expectations for the French consumer? The good news is, thanks to the very, very good and the best PR ever done on Israel destination we've got, with the vaccine campaign. You know, in France, Israel, speaking about Israel is always a challenging situation. And for those who live in France or work in France, you know that. And thanks to the vaccination campaign that you made in Israel, we've got a very, very, very amazing PR in all the support that basically are normally not friend of Israel, but now let's say that we've got a lot of new friends. So it's a very good news for the sellers, because French people know that Israel is a very good destination, clean destination, safe destination. And even French who speak with me every day, like I am the vaccine girl and the news of Israel, ask me, but why in France is not managed like in Israel? I don't know. But You know, French people feel that we only reach 3% of the population, and we know by the news that you reach half of the population, so there is a big gap, and which shows that we are so late. And let's just remember that France is supposed to be the first country for tourists in incoming in the world, and we've got only 3% vaccinated people. So good luck for Atout France and for incoming tourism in France.
So it's actually a real opportunity for us.
Yeah, for that, sure. We didn't need to reassure people that Israel is safe. It's okay, it's in everybody mind. So, the second step. How people French can go to Israel? First, we would like to just get the PCR test before, mandatory for sure, at the arrival if you wish, during, why not, at the departure if you wish, but please, 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 not a vaccine passport or we'll never travel again in France for sure. If we need a passport with a vaccination validation, whatever, French people will never travel again. I'm so afraid about that. I really hope that PCR test will be enough. Please, please. Otherwise, it would take so long for French tourists to travel again. So for you in Israel, what will be the first market we will come to Israel? For me, it's only my point of view. Huh? Repeaters. I'm sure they will be the first to come in Israel as soon as you will open again the border. For me, when I talk about repeaters, it's all the community, you know, the Jewish community in French, which are a very good customer for you. It's not more complicated for me to sell to French Jewish tourists than to Israeli tourists, because you used to sell to these people during 1 year. So do exactly the same, but with the French speech, and it will be okay. So let's say that all the community customer will not travel only by themselves, will not travel only directly online, will not travel only directly without you. I really think you can make exactly the same that the tourist industry made in France, to add added value, to add services, to add more than everything to reach this customer, because for sure they've got a lot of strength, because they stay longer in Israel, they are family, so there is more people when they travel. I really think if you propose added and dedicated value, for sure you can reach this customer into your product, for sure. And also pilgrims, because as you know, we've got a lot of touch with them before the crisis, and now when the border will reopen again, for sure they will come back as soon as the border are open. And the good news is, when we talk with the head of travel and pilgrimage, they all say that now they want to come again, not on the first pilgrimage, no, on the second travel, on the FIT, on new place, take more time, discover parts of Israel. There is a really big wish of explore more of Israel for the pilgrim, but in a new way. So it's up to you to propose new product dedicated for these people who already traveled to Israel and now would like to discover new place and to stay more longer in Israel than the 7 days, and that's it. I really think there are two big customers that you can reach, for sure. So, what about the B2B? So the B2B, it's always the same. They would like a lot of dedicated offer, like early booking and special deal for the B2B. They would like to have a very unique offer that they can propose to the customer, and to be sure that the customer will not find the same exactly offer on the website. they need to have a very specific offer. And they are all sure, especially the general market, that we can reach new market, like Fly and Drive, FIT, a la carte. We can really work on this new customer and new market and increase this travel, because it was just the beginning before the pandemic situation, and now here we go again. So for that we need product, we need package, and we need offer. And I think also we can highlight other season, not only during celebration. The general market need to know that September, November can be a good month to travel in Israel, and they can, I think, increase the forecast for this month, and they can obtain good price, and it's good for the general market to see that Israel is not so much expensive. So expectation for all the B2B in France: more flexibility, last minute booking, no cancellation fees if is it possible, or very lot of flexibility in all condition and fees. And they really need you to help them, because French customers are really expect that now you need flexibility and to be, you know. But I think you can work on a package, like, you know, for gastronomy with thematic, leisure, wellness, and you can offer like other destination, because I never saw that in Israel, like if you book 3 nights, get one free. If you book in breakfast, you can have board offered. If you are on a moon, you have a free upgrade. Or if you book 2 nights in Jerusalem in our hotel, you can have 1 night free in Tel Aviv. Some kind of stuff that all other destinations already propose. But in a way, it's general to all the destination. Like if you book now for a departure in September, you have an early booking reduction at 100 whatever. But we really need a big same communication with price, you know? Lot of destination work like that. So I think Israel perhaps need to improve on that and try to make like a very dedicated offer for each market. But I think it's really important, because even if after all the crisis and all the change that we will see, because we will be in front of a new tourism after the crisis, perhaps people would like more sustainable tourism, more responsible tourism, I don't know, perhaps more digital, but whatever. With this renaissance, we need to find new ID to increase figures and customers. So I really think that we need to show that safety and security, it's okay. We got it thanks to the very good PR that we've got for the vaccine campaign. But we need to show that the price, because I'm sure the price will still get a very important for customer to choose a destination, that Israel can be a good deal. Of course, it will be more expensive than Jordan, it's sure, it's not the same condition on spot. But we need to show that they can have some deal on some period. So that's why I like to focus on low season, and perhaps you can make a very global offer on the low season for one market like honeymooners, or for one market like city breaks. You can improve on this kind of thing, because I think it will be very significant for the French market. Voilà. The team. So in Paris, we are three. You've got Maggie, who is in charge of press trip, hosting, and all fair. You've got also Laurent, who is in charge of all communication. And you've got me. So me, it's all B2B. Okay, if you need anything about airline, airport, travel agency, tour operator, whatever, reach me. I'm more than pleased to help you or assist you on whatever. And that's why I would like to insist that we would like to see you this year, please, in France. Yeah, you can come in France. There is not only Berlin or London. We don't have ITB or WTM for sure, but we've got our own fair. And just to remind you that French is still the first market from Europe to Israel. So yes, the challenging situation with France is you need to speak French to make business. Yes, but many business need to be done. And if you don't come, you cannot meet people. And I think it's really important. So for this year, to make the bigger fair in Paris in October, Topresa IFTM, and we also supposed to make DITEX, which is in Marseille, you know, the second airport for the direct flight in France. So it's very important that we can show you guys, and you came, and you will come, because we need you to increase and push Israel destination. Because we don't have any product, we don't have any promotion. It's up to you. We need you. You are the best ambassador of the destination. So we need you on the fair, and we need you to increase our figure on the destination. Voilà. So if you've got any question, whatever.
Bonjour, Laureline.
Bonjour.
Comment vas-tu?
Très très bien.
Which date is DITEX, please?
The DITEX is postponed, but the good news is they try really to make it this year for real, not on the digital way, because all destination and tour operator refuse to make it on digital way. So for sure there will be a DITEX for real in Marseille, but when they say normally in November.
Okay.
We don't have any official emails or details or whatever, but normally in November. I think Marseille will be a great opportunity also for any one of you if you want to come. And for Paris, it's October because we already get the date.
Hopefully.
Yeah, we believe.
I have a quick question.
Yeah.
Yes. If there are any presentation, if we can learn from other countries' experience that are doing marketing to France, and you know, successful examples that we need to learn from, we would have to see these examples. You know that, for example, I don't know, Greece is doing something special. They are, beside of repackaging like you offer, they offer 1-2-3, or they are emphasizing the issue of health in that way or another.
Yeah.
So give us a lead of successful stories in the French market so we can learn and adjust.
I will try to find the last offer that they proposed, because I used to work as a marketing manager on destination, so I used to work with promotion of destination and global destination. But I will ask to product manager, you know, for this year, what was the best offer and what was the best offer for which customer also. Can be helpful for you. But for sure, when you make a communication of destination and say, if you go in Israel for 4 nights and book 4 nights and obtain 1 free, for sure it's a very clear message for the customer, because we are in competition with Dubai, Abu Dhabi, with Greece, with a lot of place. And it will be challenging if we would like to increase new customer, like general market, to come to Tel Aviv to give them this kind of offer. We don't have to think they will come because we are open. It's not enough.
Yeah, okay, so two more issues. The issue of vaccination certification in France. If we can see, or if you have any lead, because we didn't hear from our government that there is any negotiation for validating, accepting the part or whatever certification is being issued in the French market. So this is highly important. And another thing that you mentioned, you emphasize the issue of the price.
For sure.
And we are reading many articles and surveys that are saying that if you promise more health safety, people will compromise the issue of the price, because Israel, as you know, as usual, is not cheap, and somehow our friends from the hotels even raising the prices for this year, for the end of this year.
Yeah, I agree with the, I totally agree with your point of view that people can make some compromise, but there is a lot of competitors with Israel destination, you know, in the Mediterranean area. So of course is one of things, but you need to take into consideration that when people would like to travel, they share and they compare. So when they share between all of them what they see, if you can have like 3 nights in Israel for the same price, like let's say five nights in Greece, or like five nights in Dubai or whatever, they will share and compare for sure. So let's say it's not, you don't need to make a low price, you need to make the good price.
Yeah, okay.
We are not alone on the map, okay? We are surrounded by competitors for travelers. Because people who would like to travel, first, they would like the safety, and for that, like I said, the PR of Israel is really good on that, so for sure, we've got the strength for that, it's good. But I think price will be also a very important matter. And perhaps for the new tourism, customer will make the choice of sustainable tourism, responsible tourism. I hope so, but I'm sure price will be very, very significant for the choice of people. Because when you go to travel, it's an option. You don't have to travel. It's not mandatory to travel when you are a tourist. It's a choice.
Okay.
So it's a very, very, you know, the world crisis, etymology of the world crisis, it's from the Greek, and it means between making choices and deciding, okay, and deciding. So I think let the customer, they will make the choice and decide it. But I think to be in the top of destination, we need to be in the good price. And that's why I propose to very focus on special offer for very special and dedicated market.
Thank you. I just want to clear that regarding to Greece, nobody is talking about it, but right now the requirement is 7-week quarantine on the entrance. They say we are open, everybody is quoting like Greece is starting doing business, but if you are coming from France, right now the requirement is 7 days
of quarantine. Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions?
We just need our country to open, Israel, to open for tourists.
Yeah.
So that's the big problem.
Israel to coming back. You need to open the border for everyone.
What I can tell you that we are working now on a pilot. We're probably going to enter, and it was not published, and it will not be published. We're going to enter probably 20 to 30 groups during May. to see how it's work, and then probably if everything goes right, then mid-June to mid-July, we're expecting that some movement will start with the vaccination tourist at the beginning. And what is happening around the world, that the countries are moving from the certifications of vaccination into tests on interest, a higher level test than the PCR. And this is where we are going now also in Israel. And we are talking about the kind of test that will be done on the entrance. And so the issue of vaccination will be less important probably. I don't want to go into details, but it's being discussed, and hopefully we'll have news with this regard very soon. The Minister of Tourism with PIMI is working hard on this, and I'm sure they will bring us some good results in the near future.
Good news, because just to remember, the slide 3 of my presentation focus on the fact that we only get 3% of the population vaccine in France. So if the certification of vaccination will be not the future of tourism, it will be great news for French people.
Yeah, I think it's all over. It's not going to work. No countries can actually read it and validate other countries' documents. It's only a paper document that you can never know if it's reliable or not.
Des questions, messieurs, dames? Des suggestions? Suggestions? Des interrogations? Interrogations?
Well, thank you so much, Laureline. If we don't have any other questions.
Merci tout le monde. Et then you pas,
hope to see you again in Israel soon. Or in France. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, everybody.